classmates. Four evictions. Who goes? You decide.
Tonight, it's Quadruple Eviction Friday! Oh, yes!
Does it feel good tonight?
Feels great.
Good. Now, if you were even considering leaving the house, then do not. Absolutely forget about it.
Why not?
Because tonight, George, is the most important night of the series so far.
Why so?
Well, because eight housemates
are up for eviction, everybody, and unbeknownst to me, time in Big Brother history tonight, four of them will be leaving the house for good, everybody.
I know what that music means.
What does it mean?
I know what it means.
Is that weird, creepy Bob Reiter fellow?
Isn't he weird?
Now, it turns out Bob's predicted what's going to be on the show tonight. They sang on X Factor and came so close to winning. They come in a pair and they never stop grinning.
Same difference.
Same difference, everybody. You should know her by now, and the nation all love her, the number one fan and queen of Big Brother,
Davina McCall!
Davina McCall, everybody's coming there! Right, she went in the house, but left this time last week. She's back on the prowl, and it's young men that she seeks.
It's got to be Joe.
It is Joe. Hello, Joe.
Hi, Joe. But let's not forget about last night's show. Who could have predicted that Corin would look so good in a bin bag? Nathan and Rachel would become a couple, and John James would go to the diary room and ask to leave. Actually, I think even we could have predicted that one, yeah.
Yeah, you're right.
Bob would like you to be reunited with one of your old housemates.
Look at you.
Have you missed me?
Of course I've missed you.
Did you not?
Yeah, did not. When someone tells me that I can't do something, it makes me more determined to do it. I've turned down a lot of stuff, actually.
Yeah, I'll bet you have, yeah.
I don't know what the hell your problem is with me, John. Take your stuff and just leave.
Got a girlfriend.
No way!
Yeah.
What's she called?
Rachel.
She's with Rachel at
Nair and I just need to go. I'm 24 years old. I can work my way around. I can find... You will give me the location of where my mum is, and I'll find it. I don't think you understand. I'm stressed.
Would he have been sorry if Nathan weren't going out with Rachel? Let me have a think about that. No, the guy, well, wouldn't give a rip.
Corin telling it like it is. I love it. Right, it's been one of the most eventful weeks in Big Brother history, so who better to predict what's going to happen next than Davina McCall? Was eventful, and then this week
we're just thinking, phew, let's just have a relaxing week before Friday.
Did you ever think you'd see the house submerged in water and housemates being evacuated?
And when somebody said it had been flooded, I assumed that it had sort of come from down below, but it was from the heavens.
Yeah.
It was catastrophic.
It really
wasn't it?
I mean, just everything coming through the roof. No,
it can't have been socks.
Socks and bits and pieces.
Yeah.
I mean, what's that about? Now, this week has all been about predictions and dilemmas.
Yes.
So we thought we'd have one with you.
Oh, good. That's okay. Right. Yes.
So
good.
If you have a look under here.
Yeah.
And we'd like you to.
Yeah.
Oh, here you go. Let's go backwards.
Thank you.
Okay. Break it. There you go.
Oh God.
Right. So since Stillman's classic, I don't want to dance.
Too embarrassing.
Or be handcuffed to a gorilla for the rest of the interview.
Gorilla.
Yeah. Get the gorilla in. Brilliant. Gorilla.
Oh God.
Okay. So this week's task, all about predictions.
Oh, I think it's been brilliant. There. Look, Mr. Gorilla. There. Oh, you growled at me.
What's your favourite part of it being?
What, the task?
Yeah.
Do you know what? It made me feel all warm and gooey seeing Ben.
It was nice, wasn't it?
Ben and Mario handcuffed together. It was a really nice moment, and we needed a nice moment this week.
And Mario kind of took him out almost with that hug.
Yeah, it was. And the music
was so pleased
that they played when we on the nightly show, and they did the slow-mo with them running across the garden.
Amazing.
It was really,
I wanted
really
to see him in Baywatch pants and everything. It would have been great.
Yeah, he'd have quite liked that as well, wouldn't he, Mario?
And Nathan and Rachel went back into the house, and we've got
Nathan and Rachel.
We've got a Big Brother couple.
Let's just discuss that. How selfish of them to not get together when they were in the house.
I know. Well, she didn't really have much time, did
she? Selfish. She could have got it on with him in a week. Come on.
Shame on her! Now, tonight, quadruple eviction, first time ever in Big Brother history. But how do you think they're going to take it in there? Because they're really not expecting four tonight, are they?
Do you know, it's funny, the housemates. I think they might find it quite unsettling because I think they're expecting two.
Yeah.
I would expect that they're thinking we'll definitely have two. But yeah. I think that it's unsettling. Anything that's out of the normal that you haven't predicted at this stage of the game is a bit scary.
Yeah. And very finally, who do you want to see in the final? Obviously, Josie's in there.
Well, Josie's in there, and I think she deserves to be in there. And yeah. I'm very pleased.
She's been
and
brilliant.
Her sticking up for the sisters this week, yeah. I've been really, really impressed with that.
Isn't it weird? It's normally the girls that are the bitchy ones. So, the issue, it's the boys.
I know Corinne's a bit like Marmite. People yeah. love her. But, you know, I think she's been happy. She's played the game. She's always been involved. I'd like to see her in there somewhere.
OK.
I'm trying to think who else. I'd quite like Sam Pepper to be in the
final. Yeah, you got another bit of Sam Pepper.
To say that.
Yeah. Davina, thank you so much. It was brief, but it's always a pleasure.
You know, it's always a pleasure.
Thank you. Davina McCall, everybody. So, eight housemates, four evictions, who goes? Here are the all-important numbers.
Emma, could you just give me the key? Because I need to get out, because I've got to go and do the rehearsals.
I seem to have lost it.
No, but I need to go. I've got to go.
I'll try and find it.
To evict Andrew, call 090-11-323-015. To evict Corinne, call 090-11-323-003. To evict Dave, call 090-11-323-004. To evict JJ, call 090-11-323-018. To evict John James, call 090-11-323-007. To evict Mario, call 090-11-323-009. To evict Sam, call 090-11-323-020. To evict Steve, call 090-11-323-013. Calls cost 50p from a BT landline. Other networks may be higher and mobiles will be considerably more. 15p from each call will be donated to charity. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes in tonight's show. So tonight, anybody could be going with me. Now the people who've been glued to the screens for the last 73 days. It's the friends and family, everybody. How are we doing, gang? Right, we've got some viewers' questions for you. First up, we've got Andrew's friends and family, his brother Steve. Andrew, first question from Stasia. Andrew is going to be such a stud when he comes out of the house. Do you think he'll get a girlfriend?
Yeah, definitely. He's a popular guy outside the house, and I'm sure he'll have his pick of girls.
He's going to be fighting him off, isn't he? Yeah. Right, Jenna, Corinne's friend. Alex got a question for you. Has Corinne been playing games in the house over the last few weeks?
No, definitely not. I think what you see with Corinne's what you get, and she's being herself.
You reckon?
Yeah.
All right, Jenna, good luck tonight. We've got Donna here. How you doing, my love? Welcome
Fine,
back
you.
Again,
thank
again,
you
again. Saskia's question is, what will you be doing to celebrate Dave's return home? She's just assuming he's definitely going to be out tonight.
Oh, well, we'll have lots of food, Chinese, Indian, yeah? whatever. Lots of nice bubbly.
Or both, maybe.
Yeah, both.
Or both,
definitely.
Really treating. Push the boat out.
Yeah.
OK, good luck tonight. Maz, how are you doing? This is JJ's
fine,
mum.
Thank you.
We've got a question in from Ian. It says, why does JJ agree with everything that John James says?
I really don't think he does.
Hasn't he got a mind of his own?
He has got a very good mind of his own, but they're two boys that are the same age that get on well. Not everybody argues with their friends.
Right, OK, fair dues. All right, good luck tonight, my love. Helena's back for another night, John James's mum. Lucy's got a question. It says, do you think John James is really going to fly the nest and go and move to Bristol and leave you all alone?
Well, he's got to fly the nest one day, hasn't he?
Yeah? Do you think he's going to move there for Josie?
He might, yeah.
We'll have to wait.
He's got my blessing
she's
if he
not
does.
She's not convinced. And then we've got Laura, Mario's famously outspoken friend. So lovely to have you back on the show, my dear. Big question is, this is from Donna. She wants to know, Mario and Andrew have been spending a lot of time together. Is there any chemistry between those two?
Not at all. I honestly think it's more of he looks at me like a little brother. He wants to look after him and show him the way to go.
But he was trying to look at him going to the bathroom the other day.
No, it isn't like that at all.
That's just straight up weird. Isn't it? Hey, right. We've got... Kane here, Sam's friend, Elise. Yeah. Oh, they like Come Sam, on. Or they like you, Kane. Who knows? They want to know why is Sam so immature for his age? That's from
Elise. I don't know why he's so immature, but Sam, that's him. You know, each to their own. Life goes on.
Right, so you just got to take him out of his, basically.
That's Sam Pepper. If you weren't him, it won't be Sam Pepper.
All right, Kane, lovely talking to you, mate. And then Ian, Steve's friend, lovely to see you on the show again, mate. Sophie wants to know, are we seeing the real Steve, Ian?
Hi, Sophie. Well, Steve's not a person to get involved in petty arguments.
Yeah.
He done on the outside, and he certainly went on the inside. He's a straight-up bloke, honest-to-goodness bloke.
Right, OK, but do you think he's really being him?
Yeah, he's been him.
All right, lovely, and thank you very much, mate. Now, how would you guys like the chance to win 10 seconds of airtime to give your plea as to why your housemate should be going through to the final? How would you like that, guys? You'd love that, wouldn't you? And as you know, this week's shopping task is all about predictions. Josie confirmed Bob Reiter's prediction that she would suck her thumb on more than 5 occasions. She actually sucked it 38 times during 3 days. But on the day of her big argument with John James, exactly how many times did she suck her thumb? I want you to write it down and then show it to the camera, OK? Write it down, guys, quick as you can. How many times, quick as you can, how many times did she suck her thumb? Quick as you can, guys. Come on now. We all ready? Right, show your answers, if you will, please. OK, what we got? We got 18. I don't know what that's meant to be. 100,000, 15, 7, 12, 15, 12. Well, we're going to get... Well, only one person knows the answer, don't they? It's Bob Reiter, everybody. Come on in, Bob Reiter. I want the answer, Bob. The answer, guys, 20... Can I see your answers, please? See your answer again. Answer here, 23. We've got Ian, Steve's buddy here. You were closest, you got 18. You've got 10 seconds. Straight down that camera there, fella in the white shirt. Go on.
Steve is an excellent bloke. He does so much good work for so many people. He can benefit so many people like Blesma, Dogs for Disabled, Cobras. He's an excellent bloke.
Thank you very much, and give him a big round of applause. Right, still to come. On Quadruple Eviction Friday, we'll be unleashing the cougar with last week's evictee, Joe. An X Factor finalist, same difference, trying to predict what's more daunting, our eviction crowd or Simon Cowell. We'll see you in 4. Welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. We are inside the house and it's time for the news, everybody. Right, now, yesterday at 12:24 p.m, Big Brother gave John James the opportunity to speak on the phone with ex-housemate Nathan. John was terrified that he had upset Nathan after bad-mouthing the new love of his life, Rachel. This is what Nathan had to say.
The only issue I've got with you, John, is you're upsetting people very close and dear to me.
Yeah.
You're not giving Rachel a chance. You hardly got to know her. You basically don't know how much I care about that girl and how much a lot of people in the outside world have a lot of love for that girl, and you're not giving her a chance, John. And basically, and the same issues with Corinne. The issue in between me and you, John, I'm not going to climb over the wall and kick your ass, John. It's all the way it's going to go.
Yeah.
I just want you to apologise to someone very close to me, you know what I mean?
Yeah, nah. All right then, mate.
All right, get your head down and stop growling, pal, yeah?
Take it easy, mate.
Bye-bye.
Oh, but will he ever apologise to Rachel? Good news is, guys, the housemates have come back out, because for a minute there, we were filming absolutely nothing. Now, at 1:51 p.m. yesterday, Titan re-entered the house, everybody. He gave Steve the choice of playing the housemates, his nominations for them, or their nominations for him. And you guessed it, he chose the latter. Ouch.
You know, because we had a bit of a playoff. Hey! We had a bit of a whisper.
My first nomination this week is Steve. In terms of going forward, it would probably be a less of a loss for me if Steve was in Europe than it would be if some of the other guys were in Europe.
Cheers, Dave. I nominated you once.
Oh, that's a bit awkward, wasn't it, Dave? Bringing the predictions task to an end, Bob Reiter proved that his close observations of the housemates had paid off. At 8:06 p.m, Big Brother revealed that they had fulfilled 11 of Bob's 15 predictions, thus failing the task. How predictable.
We'll crack 3 very weak jokes. I will refer to the glory on more than 15 occasions. We'll spend at least 20 minutes snuggling up with Josie. And we'll wear women's makeup. We'll walk around in Justice pants. We'll speculate about the Big Brother final.
Classmates failed 11 of Bob Wright's 15 predictions and have therefore failed this week's shopping task.
Couldn't give her a rip. Horrible.
Which means the housemates failed and they're not going to get the premium shopping budget, guys. It's back to basics, everybody. If you want to keep up to all the with all the latest moves from the house, get on the website, channel4.com/Big Brother. That's the end of the news.
Last Friday, she became the eighth person to be evicted with 39.4% of the vote. But has she managed to get her claws into some unsuspecting prey? Let's find out from Joe. All right, Joe.
Hey.
So, you're back out.
I am.
Of captivity. Have you got your claws into any young men? Has the cougar returned?
The cougar has returned, but I haven't been out on the prowl as yet.
Really? What have you been doing with your week?
This week, I've caught up with family and friends.
Yep.
Done something for my local newspaper, done an interview and some pictures and
stuff. Right, OK. Front page?
Yes, front
page. Nice. And how have Luton taken you back?
Oh, they've been so lovely, really supportive.
Yeah.
So I'm really thankful for that. They've done me proud, so I hope I've done them proud. But okay. Really lovely.
So tonight we've got quadruple eviction.
We have.
Who do you want to see walking out those doors?
OK. None of them particularly, but this is who I think will go.
Right.
I think, of course, John James will go.
Yeah.
I think Sam will possibly go. I think Steve will possibly go, and I'm not sure after that.
Right, OK, so those three you think are for sure.
Yeah.
And of the housemates that are left in, who do you think will cope best in Ultimate Big Brother? Because it's, you know, it's not far to go now.
Yeah, I would imagine Josie would cope the best. I think she'll just be very much what we've seen now.
Yeah.
And irrespective that they're supposed to
be... You think she'd be able to handle the celebs, the ex-housemates?
Yeah, definitely. She wouldn't have any problems. I'd love to see Sam in there, though.
Sam would cause a bit of trouble, wouldn't he?
Yeah,
I'd like that. Joe, thank you very much.
Thank you.
George, where are you?
I'm right here, babe. I'm right here. Now, in 2007, they were the surprise success story of The X Factor, eventually finishing third, everybody. They know all about living in front of the camera, surrounded by housemates, all desperate to win. It's same difference, everybody. How are we doing, guys? All right. Calm yourselves. Calm yourselves. Calm, please. You've been absolutely glued to this year's Big Brother, haven't you?
We have.
You've been loving it.
I absolutely love it. I love it every year, but this year especially.
There's been so many arguments. Mm. Why do you think that is?
I have no idea. I just think that, you know, it's going to get like that. I think that the more that it gets towards the final and the more that they can smell the money, I think it's just going to get hit more and more and more heated all the time.
OK. Now, you guys, you obviously spend a lot of time together. Is it inevitable that you will have some arguments?
Oh, we argue 24-7, so I can't believe that they're actually living in a house and they don't get to leave each other. They have to be there all the time. Me and Sean, you know, we get a few hours, like, we get to go home at night and get away from one another.
Oh, you don't live together?
Oh, no.
When you were in the X Factor house, so you were living together, what's it like, you know, being in an environment where everybody's desperate to win?
Oh, it's absolutely mental. I think the more that it gets, as I've already said, the more that it gets towards that, the smell of the money in the final, I think that they're just going to get absolutely, like, at
were
each
you
other.
The, were
the
you
pressure's
there
immense.
The year Ridian was? Were you
we were.
What a nightmare he must have been.
Ridian, the week of the final,
he could
went
smell
into
the cash, couldn't
silence.
He?
Literally, you were living in that house and you'd be like, how are you, Rid?
Yeah,
he was,
no
it
talking.
Was silence that week because he wanted to protect his voice. So
now, of course, with the end in sight, guys, everybody's been discussing exactly what it would mean for them to reach the final. Get your hankies at the ready. Have a look at this.
Maybe I'll still stay on Friday. What if I
love? There'd be nothing more better than to have made it all the way to the end. What
if it's please keep the mole in.
I'd love to be here for the final week. What about
I want to go right to the end.
The house would be pretty boring if I wasn't here.
I would love to stay, you know, on this ride as long as I can.
Personally, I couldn't give a rip.
Couldn't care less. And now we're at our last few days, we've seen a real divide between between the boys and the girls. Do you think this is a wise move?
See, I think that the girls have clubbed together because they think it's girls that vote, and if they look like they're really good friends, you know, and not, like, they're sticking up for one another, I think that that's why they're being so close. But I think, really,
I don't think it's for real?
No, I don't think there's that love there.
So you think if Corinne goes, then Josie will be all right?
I think Josie will absolutely love it because she's got good banter anyway. Mm. She'll love being with the lads, and I think she'll just turn into one of the lads that week. I really think
keep your friends close and enemies closer when it comes to stuff like
very
that.
Very quickly, four of them have got to go. Who do you think it's going to be? Call it.
It's really hard. I think because it's vote to evict rather than vote to save,
You've
I think some of the
seconds.
Big characters could
You've
go.
Got
so
10
it could
seconds.
Be John James and maybe
Steve. Maybe.
And, Dave, maybe. And, I don't know, the last person. I'm sorry.
Guys, thank you very much. Give them a big round of applause.
Thank
and
you.
Get ready for your performance.
So we've got time for tonight. A massive thank you to all of our guests. Whatever you do, don't forget to watch Quadruple Eviction Show tonight. It all kicks off 9 o'clock, Channel 4.
And make sure you join us on Sunday on T4 at 11:25 when we'll be talking to all four evicted housemates plus pop sensation Jamelia.
Here's the same difference.
Come on! Come on, we have to get the people.